السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
So in our previous hadith reading series, we discussed hadiths 31 to 35 from Kitab al-Ilm of Sahih al-Bukhari. Now 36 to 39. Under Kitab al-Ilm, same Kitab. باب من أعاد الحديث ثلاثا ليفهم عنه. من باب regarding chapter regarding من أعاد الحديث, one who repeats the hadith, repeats the talk ثلاثة,
three
times ثلاثة, ليفهم عنه, to make it understand for others. Other fahima,
understood.
So repeating one's talk, you know, thrice, in order to make it understand for others. Okay, regarding this hadith. حدثنا عبده حدث قال حدثنا عبد الصمد قال حدثنا عبد الله بن المثنى قال حدثنا ثمامة بن عبد الله عن أنس عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه كان إذا سلم ثلاثة وإذا تكلم بكلمة عادها ثلاثة. Narrated أنس رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم from Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه كان, certainly Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was, إذا سلم ثلاثة, whenever Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked permission to enter a house, he knocked the door twice with the greeting assalamu alaikum. Thalatha
three times.
So when one say when one enter the house, other's house, he should ask permission, he should say assalamu alaikum. But sometimes when the person say salam, assalamu alaikum, the people inside may not hear it. So it should be repeated thrice. Then even after that, no permission is granted or no response is there, you have to
return,
go back. Okay. So annahu kana idha sallama thalatha, whenever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked permission, or whenever sallallahu alaihi wasallam greeted persons, he greeted with salam, assalamu alaikum, three times. Wa idha takallama bi kalimatin aadaha thalatha. Wa idha takallama bi kalimatin, kalima word. Whenever he spoke a sentence or a word or a thing, said a thing, aadaha thalatha. Aada means
repeated.
Aadaha thalatha, he used to repeat it thrice. Kana, he used to repeat it thrice to make others understand. Okay, next hadith, same content, a little bit different. Haddathana Abdatu bin Abdullah, Haddathana Abdus Samad, Kala Haddathana Abdullah bin Musanna, Kala Haddathana Thumamatu bin Abdullah, and Anas عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه كان إذا تكلم بكلمة أعادها ثلاثة حتى تفهم عنه, وإذا طلع قوم فسلم عليهم سلم عليهم ثلاثة. Narrated Anas رضي الله عنه. Whenever Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم spoke a sentence or said a thing, he used to repeat it twice so that the people could understand him, understand it properly from him. Okay. And whenever he asked permission to enter, he knocked the door thrice with the greeting assalamu alaikum. Whenever he said assalamu alaikum, to a group of people, he used to say it thrice. So if one person did not hear, then we have to repeat the salam, greeting. Okay, sometimes may not hear, the other person may not hear, then we have to repeat it. Not only when we enter into a house, it is applicable when we say salam to a group of persons or to a person like that. Okay, sometimes the person may not hear, so we have to repeat it. We may not say, I have said assalamu alaikum, or I have said greeting. I have greeted you. You didn't respond. Not like that. Say, repeat it. Assalamu alaikum. Say assalamu alaikum. Then, if the person didn't hear, he may not reply. Okay. Then you have to say. You have to say what? Assalamu alaikum again. Then, again, assalamu alaikum. If the person didn't hear. Okay. Next, this. حدثنا مسدد قال حدثنا أبو عوانة عن أبي بشر عن يوسف بن مالك ماهر عن عبد الله بن عمرو قال تخلف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في سفر سافرناه فأدركنا وقد أرهقنا الصلاة صلاة العصر ونحن نتوضأ فجعلنا نمسح على أرجلنا ويل للأعقاب من النار مرتين أو ثلاثة فنادى بأعلى صوته ويل للأعقاب من النار مرتين أو ثلاثة. Narrated Abdullah ibn Amr. Once Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم تخلف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah's Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم lagged behind us. Lagged behind us. تخلف means
lagged behind.
خلف وراء. In front is a Amam. Okay. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fi safarin. In a journey. Safarnahu. We traveled. So, in a journey, we traveled. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lagged behind once. So, we and the Prophet were traveling. Then, one day, he lagged behind us. Okay. Then, فَأَدْرَكِنَا and we reached it. وَقَدْ أَرْحَقَنَا صَلَاةِ الْأَسْرُ and the Asr prayer which was overdue, Asr prayer, it's time, okay, overdue. Then what did we do? What did they do? وَنَحْنُ نَتَوَلَّهُ and we were performing wudu. You are performing wudu. No. Why are you? We are performing wudu ablution. We are performing ablution for the asr prayer. فجعلنا نمسح على أرجلنا and then we were just rubbing our wet hands over our arjul. Arjul means
legs.
Jam'u plural form. Rijil jamu, rijil jamu, rijil jamu rijal. No. Rijil jamu, arjulin. Rajul jamu,
rijal.
Rajul means man, person. Okay. Yes, person. Rijal. Rajul jamu, rijal. Rajul means man. Rajul means man, person. Rijal. Rijil means leg. Leg. Arjul.
Legs.
Okay. فَجَعَلْنَا نَمْسَهُ عَلَىٰ أَرْجُلِنَا. So, we were not properly washing our legs. We were just passing our wet hands over the, over our legs. Okay. Then, فَنَادَىٰ بِعَوَلَىٰ صَوْتِهِ. Then, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came there. He reached. He was lagging behind them. Okay. فَنَادَىٰ بِعَوَلَىٰ صَوْتِهِ. Nada means?
Called.
بِأَوْلَىٰ صَوْتِهِ
in a
higher sound. صوت means
sound.
Higher sound. وَيْلُ لِلْأَعْقَابِ مِنَ النَّارِ وَيْلُ لِلْأَعْقَابِ مِنَ النَّارِ أَعْقَابِ مِنَ النَّارِ. That is, save your heels from the fire. So, or woe to the feet. Okay, the heels. Means, you have to wash your legs properly. Otherwise, your ablution or wudu will be batil. Wudu will be void. Then your prayer, salah, will not be accepted. Okay? That's why. Save your heels from the fire. Not really that. Okay? Whenever, if we wash thoroughly, properly, during ablution, that part will be saved from the hellfire. Okay? Saved from the hellfire. Then, marrataini aw thalatha. So here, the point is that he repeated it twice or thrice. Marrataini means twice. How? Or thalatha, thrice. Okay. Thalatha, six now. Three. Babu ta'lim ar-rajuli amatahu wa ahlahu. Chapter. A man teaching religion or Islam to his woman slave and his family. So we know in earlier times there was slavery. Okay, slavery. But Islam, though Islam didn't abolish slavery as such, it minimized the hardships, the hurdles of the slaves. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded his followers to behave politely to the slaves. Okay? To behave politely, to consider them as brothers and to, not to compel them tasks which were very heavy for them. Okay? Understand? Voila. Yes. So, at that time, it was impossible to abolish slavery as a whole. Slavery as a whole. It cannot be, it could not be abolished at that time. Okay. So, the social and economic situation was like that. If the slaves were all were freed, then most of the slaves, they had no abode at all. They had no relatives. Many of the slaves had no relatives or no abode, no property like that. Okay. So Islam paved the way for the abolition of slavery. Well, it minimized the hurdles, sufferings of the slaves. Okay. Then. So here, أخبرنا محمد هو بن سلام قال حدثنا المحاربي قال حدثنا صالح بن حيان قال عامر الشعبي حدثني أبو برداء عن أبيه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So أبو برداء رضي الله عنه reports from his father, that is أبو موسى الأشعري. قال he said قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said ثلاثة لهم أجران. رجل من أهل الكتاب آمن بنبيه وآمن بمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم والعبد المملوك إذا أدى حق الله وحق مواليه ورجل كانت عنده أمة فأدبها فأحسن تأديبها وعلمها فأحسن تعليمها ثم أعتقها فتزوجها فله أجران. Okay. Narrated Abu Burda's father رضي الله عنه عنهما. Okay, may Allah be pleased upon both of them, Abu Burda and his father. So Abu Burda reports this hadith from his father. Okay, then. Qala, he said, Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Thalathatun lahum ajran, three persons, lahum, for them, there is ajran. Ajran? Ajran? Ah, yes. Reward. Ajran means two rewards. Ajr means reward. Ajran, two rewards. So a person, three persons will have double reward. Double reward or two rewards. One category is that Rajulan min ahlil kitab amana bi nabihi wa amana bi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rajul, a person from the people of the scriptures who believed in his prophet, that is Jesus alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, or Musa alayhi salam, Moses, Prophet Moses, or Musa alayhi salam, and then believed in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, that is embraced Islam. So, during the time of Isa alayhi salam, he believed in Isa alayhi salam, or upon the coming of, advent of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, as it is predicted in the scriptures of Torah and the Injil, yes, previous scriptures, he believed in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. So he believed in his prophet, that is Isa alayhi salam or Musa alayhi salam, and then he believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam also. Then he will have two rewards, double the rewards. Okay, double the rewards. Well, Abdul Mamluk. Now, next category of persons, who may get, will get two rewards or double rewards. Abdul Mamluk, idha adda haqqallahi wa haqqa mawalihi. A person, a slave person, who discharges his duties to Allah and his master. So, for a person, for a slave person, there are limitations. Okay, there will be limitations at that time also, at that time. Then, even then, he discharged his duties to his master and to Allah. Then he also will get double reward. Okay, double the reward. Then, another person, other category, وَرَجُلٌ كَانَتَ عِنْدَهُ أَمَةٌ. A person under his custody, or under his custody, there was a slave woman, a master of a woman slave, or a person under his custody, there was a slave woman, Amat. And what did he do? فَأَدَّبَهَا. He educated her, the culture, he taught her culture, Islam. فَأَحْسَنَ تَأْدِيبَهَا. And her تَأْدِيب was in a good manner, in a best possible manner. He taught her good manners, good manners. Then وَعَلَّمَهَا فَأَحْسَنَ تَعْلِيمَهَا. عَلَّمَ means taught, and he educated her in the best possible way, and she was educated also. Then she did get education from that person, from her master. Then ثُمَّ أَعْتَقَهَا. Then he freed her, and he freed her. So freeing the slaves is considered as a great thing, as a virtuous thing in Islam at that time. No, there is no slavery. So freeing of slaves, no meaning. Okay, follow. Then ثُمَّ أَعْتَقَهَا فَتَزَوَّجَهَا. So after the her freeing, after freeing her, he married her. He married her. So even before freeing her, he can use her as his wife, or in Islam, woman slave is permitted to be used for his sexual purpose. Even then, he educated the girl, educated the lady, and he taught her Islamic things, religion. Then he freed her, then he married her. Okay, then falahu ajran, then he will get two rewards. No, so this about slaves, you have seen one hadith earlier. إخوانكم خبركم. الله Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to Abu Dharr al-Ghifari رضي الله عنه once, إخوانكم خبركم جعلهم الله تحت أيديكم فمن كان أخوه تحت يده فليطعمه مما يأكل وليلبسه مما يلبس ولا تكلفوهم ما يغلبهم فإن كلفتموهم ما يغلبهم فأغلبوهم. إخوانكم خبركم, your slaves are your brothers. جَعَلَهُمُ اللَّهُ تَحْتَ أَيْدِيكُمْ. Allah has made them under your custody. Then فَمَنْ كَانَ أَخُوهُ تَحْتَيَدِهِ. And if one has one brother under his custody, then فَلْيُطْعِمْهُ مِمَّا يُكُلْ. He should give him proper food or what he eats, what the master eats or what the person eats. وَلْيَلْبِسُ مِمَّا يَلْبَسُ. Then he should dress him what he dresses himself. وَلَا تُكَلِّبُهُمْ مَا يَغْلِبُهُمْ. He should not compel him duties or works which are not affordable to that slave, to his brother slave. Okay. فَإِنْ كَلَّفْتُمُهُمْ. If he compel him, or if he ask him to do certain task which is not affordable for him, مَا يَغْلِبُهُمْ. فَأَغْلِنُهُمْ. Then he should help. The master should help in the work for the slave. The master should help him in that work. Okay. Assalamu alaikum.